Concluded the day two of our foundation course in chocolate making. Today we have done some center filled chocolates. Now these all center filled chocolates I have taught you, which are made from scratch, no ready products from the market that you put it in. And since you've learned all the products from scratch, the center fills, you can do a lot of variations. You can change your flavors. You can, you know, introduce new flavors, and you can mix match and make a combination of every center. Okay, so let's start. Today we started with our pistachio delight. Okay, this is our modak shaped mold, and where I have used pista with heart center. Okay, you can even use pistachios on the top, like how I've put on the top some pistachios for garnishing. Okay, so that's your pista with a heart center filling inside. This is a rose marzipan, which is a mixed dry fruit with a rose flavor, and we've also used rose petals on the top. Next is your Colombian coffee. We have one which is a Colombian coffee, where I have wrapped it, where I've shown you how to use a Colombian coffee bean also on the top and a coffee center inside. We've done the wrapping part as well. This is a butterscotch with a soft centered chocolate. One we did butterscotch and one with a coffee and orange combination in a liquid fill center. Okay, so we've done two liquid fill centers and the Colombian coffee. Next, we've done one more liquid filling center. Today I've taught you how to avoid that your liquid filling does not ooze out. If you notice, even this is my liquid fill center with sticky center, yes, with bubblegum flavor. It has not come out at all because we have used a shelling method where you make sure that your inside filling does not ooze out and fall out completely. Also, I taught you that be very careful in doing your shelling so that you don't set your chocolate for long, in case your chocolate should not separate out and come into two parts. So that you need to be very careful. The timing and all is very important. Okay, so then this is your bubble gum. I did something different today. This is my minty chocolate with some drizzles on it and some sprinkles on it. Then this is our date and walnut. So I have used date today. You can even use honey walnut. This is our inclusion effect of mixed dry fruits. That is your cashews and almonds. I showed you two types of dates. One is your date and almonds with pistachios garnish, and one is your candied fruits inside. Plus, I have put some fruit on the top also. This is your bounty bar. I've shown you how to wrap your bounty. So that's your bounty centered chocolate, and we also did a pina colada with the same bounty center. Okay, and these are our two cute lollipops, which I showed you how you can decorate and make your lollipops a little fancy. Okay, so we've discussed the costing of each, and I've shown you how to pack them also. These are the types of wrapping that you can do, what type of foil wrapping papers you're supposed to use, what you're not supposed to use. Okay. So I had five students today, a new student from Nagpur, and one more student who's come down from Hyderabad. So total five students, including their students from yesterday's class. Okay. Any questions?
Thank you for the class.
Thank you. You were waiting. Great.
Superb session.
Thank you. Thank you. So I'll see you all tomorrow for the advanced class.
Yeah.
Okay.
Night class.
Thank you.